Welcome to episode 141 of the Clarity Compressed podcast. My name is Paul J. Daly. As you can see, I'm not in my office today. I'm actually recording a video for something we're doing with Facebook, and we have a live event. All that to say, today we're talking about high risk versus high reward.
We're making our way through the fog of life, and clarity is understanding where we are on the map. You are here.
Let the good times roll.
This is Clarity Compressed.
So the concept of high risk, high reward is something every entrepreneur has to be comfortable with at some level or another. And I think the more successful entrepreneurs disproportionately are more comfortable with more risk because every entrepreneur faces risk in order to start a business. But not every entrepreneur does things that get noticed, which is okay. I'm not saying it's not okay to be an entrepreneur in a community and run a dry cleaner that just goes about doing solid work and providing for the community, making a great living. Nothing wrong with that. It's the backbone of so much of our country today. But today I'm talking to the entrepreneurs that are willing to take a big swing. And the big swing is something that means you could miss. It means you could lose. Actually, it means you will lose more than you win. But the bottom line is this: you can't hit home runs if you don't swing for the fence. And this is a great time to talk about this. A post from my good friend Darren Doan. It's this one right here. We'll put it up on the screen. He fired me up when he said this. And basically the post says this: high risk, high reward content that makes everyone in your industry notice you and reaches the world. That's what you're aiming for when you decide to go really big. And Darren is somebody that knows all about going really big. He's a very well-known producer, videographer. He's got an agency that's about to explode or is exploding. His videos, his music videos have more than 1 billion views on YouTube. And he fires me up when he says stuff like this. And if you look at his social content, you'll realize here's a man that's not afraid to go really big. If you haven't heard, I'm telling you right now, I decided to put on a live in-person event in my hometown of Philly on November 12th. So just in a couple weeks from now, 2-3 weeks from whenever this podcast is airing on Tuesday, there's gonna be a live event in Philly. What? A live event in the middle of a pandemic? Well, not in the middle, but a live event in a time when people are still a little hesitant. Should we get together? At least it's politically incorrect to not be hesitant to get together. And here's what I decided. In the automotive industry, every automotive event has gotten canceled this year, every single one, after March forward. There are a lot of people in our industry, in the auto industry, a lot of dealers, a lot of industry partners, and a lot of people who are supporters who want to get together and encourage one another. And I believe that getting together in person is the ultimate encouragement. Zoom calls are cool and all, and we've been on a zillion of them. Webinars are cool and all. Virtual events are cool and all. I know, I hosted them, I host them. I have an organization called the Automotive State of the Union. We love the virtual events, but there's something about being together that I believe needs to be symbolic. Symbolic in this day and age. What does that mean? Well, that means high risk, but I think it also means potentially high reward because I believe that there are a lot of people that believe the same way that I do. And that is that we can't cower to a pandemic. We have to be safe in a pandemic, but we have to put a stake in the ground and say, we are willing and encouraged and going to move forward and band together as an industry and push back on all the market forces and all the social and economic forces that are trying to push us down. And as entrepreneurs, we're willing to stand. What does that do? Oh, Paul, you're having a live event in Philly in a time when the optics might be bad or people might have a problem with that, or maybe nobody will even show up and you're gonna risk booking a venue and spending thousands of dollars to get people to come and nobody will come, and then it's just you by yourself in a venue in Philly with empty pockets. That may be the reality. When I'm recording this right now, ticket sales haven't opened yet. We have no one sponsoring the event yet, but guess what I have to do? I have to sign for the venue and the food and the staff and the camera crews and be willing to pay for it. But guess what? It's worth it. Why? Because I want to take a big swing. I want to rally people that believe the same way that I do and to encourage the people that want to believe the same way, but they're a little afraid to. And so they're sitting back and they're kind of waiting to see what everybody else does before they make a move. That's great. The world is full of this kind of interaction and this back and forth motion between people who really want to do it, people who do want to do it but are afraid to step out. And I'm saying, look, I'm willing to take the risk and step out. And that is what entrepreneurs do. That is what the people who have gotten noticed and made real change in the world have been willing to do. What are they willing to do? They're willing to lose, and they're willing to risk it. And right now I'm saying this to myself because yes, I get pregame jitters. Yes, I feel the fear of losing or the fear of spending a whole lot of money and putting myself at a disadvantage, because I believe there are other people out there that believe the same way that I do. And if you're thinking about this in your industry, I guarantee you there are other people around you that feel the same way you do, whatever the risk is. I'm not saying you have to put on a live in-person event, but whatever that is that you're debating whether or not you should start doing. And if it worked, it could be really big, but if it didn't work, it would put you back. Guess what? You'll learn more from the missed swing than you will from sitting and steadying course. I've already talked to some sponsors, and you know what they said? They said this: we really like you and all, and we support you. We want you to be successful, but we're a little nervous of the optics of the event. We're a little bit nervous that we wanna be really safe and cautious and conservative. We don't wanna put ourselves in back. You know what? I totally respect that, but guess what? I can't let that stop me, because I'm gonna be the one that gets to stand out front and saying, this is the flag I'm putting in the ground. It doesn't matter what everybody else thinks. This is what I believe. And guess what? If people line up next to me to support that, I'm gonna be really excited. If nobody lines up next to me, guess what? People will know that I had the conviction to do what I thought was right. And I don't think I can lose in that situation. I don't think my company will lose. I don't think my family will lose. Why can I say that with confidence? Because my last 17 years in business have been nothing but taking swings, and I've missed a lot, but guess what? I connected on enough of them that I was able to move forward and be the person that I am today with the business mindset that I have today and the care for one another and the understanding that there are people around there that just need somebody next to them to tell them, you can do this. Stand next to me, I'll do it with you. Stand next to me. We can go and do it together. And then if there's two of us, if there's three of us, if there's 300 of us, if there's 3,000 of us, then something's really gonna happen. So that's what today's podcast is about. High risk versus high reward content that makes everyone in your industry notice and reaches the world. That's what you're aiming for when you decide to go really big. I wanna shout out and thank my friend Darren Doan again for making that content, risking putting that out into the world so that he can inspire me, so that I can give this message to you, hopefully inspire you to step forward and go. Listen, if you want to be at that live event in Philly on November 12th, I don't know if there are any tickets left at this point when the podcast is launching. If you want to be part of it, go to dealerspushingback.com and you can see all the details of the event. We've rented an amazing venue. It's like the NBC Sports Arena at Xfinity Live. It's a really unique venue. I've never been any place like this before. It's just about a mile from where I grew up, so I'm really excited to be there. We're gonna have speakers. We're gonna have live stuff. We're gonna sing the national anthem live and in person. We're just gonna rip it. So if you can be there, hit the tickets up, grab them if there are any left, and if not, there'll probably be ways to get engaged. We're still trying to figure that out as far as virtual and how much we're streaming, how much we won't stream. But whatever it is, I hope you join us if you can. If you can't, I hope you take a big swing. Whatever that is in your life, take the swing. Be willing to miss the swing, because you'll learn more from the missed swing than you will just sitting and watching podcasts on the internet. I'll talk to you guys next week. Thank you so much. And I hope you take some big swings. If you do, hit me up. Let me know about it. I'll see you next time.